circle. Come on up. You're still just in the brush. I know I can't really get the trail, but you're not worried about the trail, right? Okay, then come up again. Four.
I don't want my face to adjust my face.
I have to take one step backwards.
Here's the guys going back down. Beautiful place. Here is the courtyard. And there's the pool up in that upper row. We're taking an early morning hike Sunday morning. We, of course, hit a closed road, so we're just going to walk as far as we can and see how close up to the trail we can get. It's just beautiful setting no matter where you are. You can hear the water. A little bit further up the roadway here, spotted a porcupine over here. Caps up here.
Yeah, goats tend to usually come out in the morning.
Well, we're still walking the road, but I'm not sure if we're going to get up as far as the parking lot and lake even, although we have come to the Maroon Bells. These are the peaks that are the site up here. And there are lakes, crater lakes down here, but I'm not sure how much further we have to walk up the roadway, so we'll see if we get there, but it is just absolutely gorgeous. That's beautiful. We're headed back down here. You get a different perspective, of course, as you head back down, but just spectacular scenery. And the bells are behind us here. I'll swing around. There's Mags just standing with me. Spectacular scene. Beautiful morning. Inching our way down, there's the Mom and Mag there, the stragglers at the moment. Isn't that gorgeous? Just gorgeous. Doesn't get much nicer than this, does it? Gluttons for punishment that we are. We've gone ahead and tackled the Ute Trail, which is a nice trail. It just takes you up over Aspen Mountain so you can look back down on the town. Hey, Maggie. Hang on, I'm gonna
put my voice on, and I'm here. Last at all, I'm here.
I'm gonna see if show where we got.
All 48, you're loading
me. This is where we hiked up to. Above Aspen.
Is it clearing up, Andy?
No, but it should be clear on the tape.
I don't know about that. Do you have an automatic focus on it?
Yep. There's Mom.
48 years old. I made it to the top.
48? But it's 450. After a hike like this.
It actually makes me feel young. Taking a tiny little... And I'm taking a tiny little rock from up here, too. Tiny.
What if Aspen runs out of rocks?
Well, then I got mine.
Aspen can buy themselves some new damn rocks.
That's right.
Yeah. Alright, it's a little shaky.
Katie?
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. They...
This is the top! I don't know. Where are you?
Uh-oh. They came up.
You're
the two stragglers. The two stragglers made it.
You're almost there. When you get to this little spot, come on over to us.
Wave, Dad.
Dad, wave.
There he is. Heart attack? He's got a heart to look after, ladies and gentlemen. Not
that way? Yeah, well, no, go the opposite way of us.
Yeah, follow the voices, Kat.
You see, she can see me.
What?
She can see me. And she points the other way. Do I go that way? sure, if you want to go the other way.
You can if you want.
It's yourself. God, you're not that far behind us.
No cabs.
For 5 minutes. Six.
Yeah, well, we stopped every 15 seconds. Oh, don't say Maggie.
Yeah, she's going to try to blame it on me that we stopped.
No,
Did I stop?
You stopped. Every freaking bit as often as I did.
That's the town of Aspen.
Yep. The one with the microphone with the headphones, right?
Hey, we got a camera in here. There's children watching. All right, we're going to pan into... Whose house is this?
Mine.
That's Katie's house. With the river running by. It's all right. It's a nice house. You like that kind of thing.
Well, were you and Dad with it?
I like the lake house.
She lied. From when she told me, Penn, it took us another 25.
Is there lake?
And we did eat, so. We started going like right.
Well, they must have sat so long that they really didn't stop. Because we did stop every 3 seconds.
Let's film back. We've done this 1,000 times, but we're gonna film where we're staying.
The
St. Regis.
See that house where we passed on the hike?
That real red one?
That is our hotel right there.
No, Mom. That way.
Maybe we're just right there.
Sure.
That's the town. There's the church.
Right there. There's that house. I see it.
Is that big field is right next to us?
That's the park.
That's this one. The ball field.
What house are you looking at?
No, I'm looking
at the
St. Regis.
If you follow Mill Street down, you can see the house where we... That's like along that stream.
Oh. I hear you. The camera is running.
That's Mom.
Yeah, we know.
Just in case we're showing this to anybody who doesn't know that that's our mother.
Yeah, I think we all pretty much... We all know.
Hey.
School, I guess it was.
That's right.
Our yard looks beautiful again.
I want to stick around here.
Memorial Day morning. It's this beautiful morning, so I feel like go ahead and shoot some more of Daddy's handiwork out here. It looks so pretty. she was just coming and how nice it was without any extra noise like lawnmowers and such. And of course, now you hear that in the background, but still very pretty nevertheless. Head out on our trip here. Hate to leave Daddy's beautiful yard though.
Me too. I'm turning it over to Katie and Andy.
Just such a great job. People walking by in the neighborhood have even stopped and commented.
You have to go up close so they can get my
swing around and we'll go ahead and get from the creek bed as well. Here we are up at Daddy's creek bed. Talk at you later. Probably finishing my lunch there. We're in Glenwood Canyon. That was the Amtrak train just going by. A beautiful spot for a rest stop, and they actually have a recreational trail, people biking and walking, and the Colorado River is right here. People rafting up and down. Beautiful spot. See if I can't catch some rafters in there. But just stepped over here to the edge and shooting back up the roadway. I see some rafters that I guess this is a put-in point right here by this rest area. The roadway cuts through the canyon here. We just sat out and had our bite to eat with some folks that are fairly local and gave us all kinds of information about their area and talking about how long it took to build this, 13 years to build through the canyon here and design it. It's a beautiful ride through the canyon here. Utah here. We hit a spot just into the state line and a viewpoint. So we're going to walk up and take a look around. We are just a nice big canyon area. To the west. Pretty good canyon. And as you swing around here, you see, of course, lots of.
Not only do you get to see
distance.
Me.
From where we came to Grand Junction. Bluffs over there.
I'd go walk out into there, but it looks like rattlesnake country.
That's not just the sun reflection, it's.
No.
Kind of reminded you of the Badlands. If you can see a lightning.
Yeah, I got
more.
Watch it, wait, stop, there's a car coming.
Here we are heading toward Moab, and we're taking the scenic route. You can see there's obviously quite a bit of desolate areas. We could give you some real vistas of what we just went through, but then we're finally hitting the point now where it follows the Colorado River here. Go down the Colorado to Moab about the next 15-20 miles, so pretty cool. Another place down the river here a little bit. It's just interesting as hell. On the roadway, which is very narrow. Very interesting arc. A little bit, you hit another spot that's just unique. There's some people that actually have stopped for a little swimming hole action. Concerned, so she's not stepping out. Just sets a shot just down the road a little bit. You can see this. Bit further here. Here's Daddy checking things out on the other side of the roadway. It's just, spectacular. Making the first stop.
It's like being dropped on another planet.
Hard to even describe it all.
No, we're not doing that.
I wonder who placed that rock up there to the left. Way up there. It's ready to peter off.
Like, okay, not going to be too gross, but it looks like little buffalo trees or something. Like, look at it, on that big smooth rock over there.
Okay. The dinosaur dropping.
They got to wonder, why did they drop there in a little pile and not slide off or anything? They're like in a little pile. Can you zoom in on that?
Yeah.
And that is a good job.
To get the scope of it.
Do you want to stand in any of these shots?
Next viewpoint, I think this is the area that we came from, what they call the Park Avenue Trail, where people can walk through there to this point. The massiveness of this stuff.
Pictures of it's just awesome.
Here's a size, if you're talking perspective here. Here's a person. Thank you. petrified dunes and just kind of an open field of...
Some 200 million years ago.
Hard winds rock from the mounds.
You're over talking. Some 200 million years ago, winds from the northwest carried tons of fine-grained sand into this area, creating an immense desert. Over time, the sand drifts were covered by other layers of sediment, compressed and cemented by quartz and calcite into Navajo sandstone. Erosion has since washed away the overlying layers, exposing the petrified dunes.
Next stop, we'll take a little bit of a walk here on the trail here. This is the area they call Balanced Rock. Look at this thing. Makes you wonder, doesn't it? I guess someday when we're reviewing film, you'll go, geez, did you film enough? But it's just such an interesting perspective, just walking all the way around it. You wonder how the darn thing can stay up there.
It's like a bunch of extraterrestrial giants came down and played with Play-Doh or roulette.
Around to what they call the window section. And you can see this area, it's just this. This isn't even it. This is just across the roadway, but we saw some people walking over in that area, and you can see some of the arches that are being created over there. Back over here and see if you can't pick up the people walking up through there. Here in this window section, I think this is called the window arch. And there's some other spots over here. Did you see Dottie up here? I'm up here at the arch, so I thought I'd just give that perspective of sitting underneath this thing. Spectacular, that's for sure. Right. I mean, you just don't get the, when you shoot these, you just don't quite get the perspective of how immense they are.
Go stand up there.
Other than, you know, there's, I've got some people walking.
Do I look crappy? I don't want to be like crapping up our picture.
You look fine, dear.
Well, then take me as perspective in this one.
All right. Down to the, what they call the south window. That's another arch here. Turret arch. You can see the blue through the arches.
Probably 100 degrees.
Start over there. We've just started our trail up to Delicate Arch. You can see the parking lot down here.
We've just started. Got another couple of miles to go. Not a lot of shade. None, to be exact. They tell you to carry a quart of water per person because it's about 100 degrees out here. Dry heat, though. Like, that makes a damn big difference.
Down the trail, and this part's pretty well, you know, marked and wide, but I'm noticing the trail of ants going up across the you can see the folks up there. And you have to go up across the rock, I guess, to up to Delicate Arch, but there's so many people out here. Won't be a problem. Yeah, we're on the hillside here. Following all the people. You don't have to worry about the rock piles telling you where you are. It's actually quite nice if you stand there.
Wow.
It has a nice breeze going. No. Yeah, actually, I think you can see the parking lot over there. So it's just a walk across the desert. And we made it up here to a Delicate Arch. It's spectacular. Boat for a trip around Lake Powell. I don't see as I turn around. You see, those are the houseboats that people rent and take out here. We're just going to take a tour ride about the morning. Go up the Rainbow Bridge. But this is the shot here as you leave the marina.
Thank you. a courtesy dock. And this is also a good time to check your camera for your film, battery, have something to drink or use the restroom. We're going to be high up here for 45 minutes.
Thank you. These are the tubes through which water is released. Show you a shot here from the room. This is the shot from our room itself at Lake Powell here, Page. And of course they have their golf course carved into the desert. And we've got this view, hopefully, of the dam and also the fireworks that go off here right at the dam. So I would anticipate that we've got a good shot of things, but we'll see. Quite a different view, no doubt about it, though.
In the morning, that water, Lake Powell, was so green, but in the afternoon, it's just a break of the wind. The sun is.
Well, we've taken our morning. We just did the tour of the dam. Really was quite interesting. And now we've come on over to the marina, and we'll probably go to the beach for a while, but just as you pull in, just to give you a shot of approaching the marina and all in the blue water against the view of the canyon. It's quite something. Seats right here in the parking lot under our window, and as you zoom in down here, there's the dam. It's the fireworks. It should be going off right down in this area here somewhere. People suggest that this is a prime seat. The people start lining up the roadway all along here in the parking lots down here, trying to get the sight lines for the fireworks display, so we'll see how it goes. Just had to film a little bit of this. I'm not going to do a lot of fireworks, but if you just went back up in the room since the weather got so threatening, we're just sitting here in our dark room, and you can just see how perfectly we're situated for watching the fireworks right over the dam.
You can see the lightning in the background.
Yeah, and the show that nature put on, and whoa, that's a good one. I filmed this just long enough until we see a huge lightning in the background, just directly behind it. It's been spectacular as well. The dam is, and the bridge is right there. That's the lightning behind it there. I have to get one of these.
Then they headed in this direction.
Okay. Going up to a canyon rim shot here.
Who said I never took you anywhere?
Tell me. Nothing.
It's just
nothing.
Bob and Dottie do the desert.
Oh my God, there's like nothing forever. Forever. 360 degrees in any direction. I'm the only sign of life.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's a scary thought.
Here we are, we've reached the edge, and there's nothing here but edge. And what you get is this view of what they call Horseshoe Bend, where the Colorado River comes here, and if you see, it kind of takes this Horseshoe Bend here and goes around that way. Get that view of it. And that's spectacular. Back, I just thought I'd try to see if you can catch any of these people down in the rim there. I'd take a quick shot here. We've come through this mountaintop and now we're on the Route 89A over to the North Rim. Just the scenery of what we're driving through. You got that mountain on this side, flat forever. And then you got this range of, I guess what is Marble Canyon, over on this side. Just the vastness of it is amazing. Taking our first walk at the canyon, and it's completely different, the opposite of where we just were. The temperatures are just mild as can be. Certainly upper elevation, pine trees everywhere. I'm just going to go ahead and walk on up to the lodge. Our first kind of opening here out over the canyon. They were up a little bit further on the path, I think not too far from the lodge. Just, you know, it's almost indescribable. I would think that would be the sunset over in this direction. Here. I'll pan around and show you the lodge.
Hey, it's our turn. Okay. Oh, it's dirty.
Oh, that's cool.
Dirty lollipop.
Couple of great natural sites here.
So where do you, I mean, the hike leads from this side, yeah? Yeah. And so do you have any?
To the back at the lodge.
Big cat.
front porch inside. Back, hopefully to beat the rain. Maybe eat dinner before it rains. And wildlife. It's right on the trail. After the heat we had up at Lake Powell, this is just, it's overcast, unfortunately, but we'll have some time, I'm sure, to see some sun and the canyon. But we'll probably have to wear sweatshirts tonight. Real nice campground. Very peaceful. Our big hike down into the canyon, you can see we've kind of come downhill, and here's a spot through the trees. The viewfinder makes it look so hazy, you may just not catch it as clearly as we do. I'm afraid at some point she's going to use that stick as a weapon on me.
Got that right.
Both commonly, it certainly has much more growth up here on the north rim. As you can see as you go down, but spectacular sights. A real definite picture-taking spot. Just from out on the rock bluff here. This is just magnificent. To get some people, but I haven't seen anybody walking there lately, but that's a trail down there, just to give you the perspective of where we are. That's the trail down there. We're way up here. Fantastic.
Oh, have fun. You're almost there.
Yeah, where should I send this?
My kids wouldn't believe it anyway.
I just need a mailing address.
Hi, Mom.
As I was recording before we were so rudely interrupted by another mule train there, I wanted to get you a shot of people up here on the ledge. Hand's not too steady there, but one-handed. But down as far as what they call the tunnel, which is in fact a tunnel in the rock. We'll stop here and head back up just outside the tunnel and get a shot here. You walk over here a little bit further. It's just the other side of the tunnel. It opens up beautifully out here. You can see the further trails and even a bridge down here. Met a fella and some boys coming up the hill from us. They had hiked from the south rim yesterday, stayed the night, came up to the north rim today, and they're headed back tomorrow. A little bit too much for us, that's for sure. We'll have a hell of a time getting back up today. It's fantastic, though. Give some perspective of the distances we're talking here. You see these people? And they're heading over here to get across the bridge. And then they'll go up the side. Head off that way. Not easy. You can see, no piece of cake. This trail seems to have a lot more step over stuff too, not a real flat, like a walking path. You really have to do some step over back and forth. You can see it's nothing but uphill. There's definitely a track. That's how I feel too. Now we're sitting around of the evening. It's not 110 like it was down at Lake Powell, that's for sure. It's been overcast, but just beautiful, peaceful campground though, here among the pines. here on the north rim. Just took a little bit of a walk. And you can see nice and quiet. Driving here, Dottie. The other night, that fire a little bit earlier was just getting started. So, just to let you know, we've got a good fire going for the evening. Just very peaceful up here, that's for sure. Burn her feet off.
Yeah. No,
just so she doesn't have to hike tomorrow.
Yeah,
she's going
to
burn her feet.
He tried to kill me this morning. I took a 2-hour nap to death. There's the
hot spot.
I didn't think about that.
Well, just a beautiful, quiet morning here. I'm going to take a drive and catch a couple of hikes out here on the north rim. Royal. And again, I just don't know if it quite captures it. And I am right here on the edge. Here is called Angel's Window. Down, you can see down to the river. Actually, this point here is where we're headed, which is Point Royal. You can see Daddy coming on. You go through all these various trees. Then you get out here. We're just not quite out to the point itself, but it is Cape Royal Point. Thank you. Now, I know it'll be up to me to edit some of this down, but doggone, it's just truly remarkable. Just want to try to capture it. Certainly right about the north room not being as crowded as the south room. I'm one of very few people up here this morning. Got a daddy out here on the edge. Nagging in the edge. She's enjoying her walk back from the point.
Practice. There's no grass. It's just all different.
I'm really recording this just to make sure Daddy doesn't take something and bring it home. I'm following you. Lovely walk. I'm looking down from this tremendous point here. People try to see how soft a touch they have. And they throw coins down on this ledge. It's about 6 feet down, but it's right on the edge there. This is just awesome. Yep. Got the little beginnings of an archer. edgewalk here is what you're looking at here. This is the Angel's window point where there where we just were doing the filming. See the folks out on the point here. Pretty cool. Through here. Not sure if you get that or not. Probably so. Cape Royal. We're stopped and taking a hike here. Out to Cape Pine, it's a couple of miles. Just a beautiful forest spot, and once again, it's like you feel like you're the only people around at all. Beautiful, beautiful morning. I think we're quite there, but we got a short path over here to the rim from the forest there.
Yeah.
I don't think you'd want to go any farther. That's beautiful. Good morning. Walked on ahead of us.
Yeah, well, I don't need to be there. I wouldn't be there. I'd get all the way up there and go like, nope, nope, I'm not going out there anyway.
Fantastic. The wildlife we've been seeing. There's a lot of little lizards. Trying to get this one here. There he is. We'll make a move again, Dad.
Yeah. He's trying to.
been really cool, but this is just a particularly pretty frame spot with these trees here and the growth nearby, and then it just opens up like a picture window out onto the canyon. Just magnificent. That's one to remember. Just pulled off here to grab a bite to eat for lunch. That's kind of the view through the trees to the canyon. There's the van. Daddy's bringing things over to the picnic table. And as we come back, we're just going to grab a table here. We're realizing, I guess these guys just get very comfortable around people here. The deer just coming on right up to the campsite area, picnic table. Isn't that weird? Grab the bite to eat. Daddy up here. Just kind of stepped out onto the ledge a little. Hard to gauge that you even captured all, you know, the shadows from the clouds, how immense it is. It's remarkable. Here's a helicopter. Yeah. Just to give you that perspective. In for the day.
Yes.
Had a nice
God
lunch.
God forbid we should have a day without a walk.
This framed beautifully. Now I hear an airplane. I'll see if I can't pick it up. There's a tour plane. Cook some dogs and beans, I think, here, but they've got some picnic sites up here, so rather than in our campsite, we drove on up here because the setting's kind of cool. As we sit and have dinner, you can look out here over the canyon. Hey, out here at Bright Angel Point. Thought it was just a few steps behind me. The vista here is stunning. Not too long before sunset. Bridge that you go out to the point, you can see that you got this sheer drop on either side. There's the path you take out to Angel Point and cross the bridge here, very gingerly.